Yeah, we on Boss Talk 101.
Oh, yo, check this out. It's your boy, Bubba Luciano. Y'all need to tap in to Boss Talk 101 with my man, E, the CEO, and Miss Jamaica.
Man, we got a very special guest in the house today, man. This guy right here, really, if you like me, a Pimp C fan, you've been hearing his name ever since the 90s, man. You know what I'm saying? And it's real good to have my boy Bobo Luciano in the building. What's going on?
Yeah, man, thanks for having me, man.
Okay.
And right around that time, they had gotten the word that Willie D had dropped out of the Ghetto Boys and they needed Big Mike to fill those shoes.
Yeah.
And so I think I don't know if it was in Friction or whatnot. What's up, Big Mike? That's my dog. Anyway.
I need to get him on the show.
Big Mike flew on back to Houston. Well, 3-2 flew to Dallas because he was going to write some things for Big Al on the next up-and-coming Nemesis album. So they said, oh, Bobo, go get 3-2 from the airport. So I had a little Hyundai, 1992 Hyundai.
Go pick him up, man.
Go pick him up. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. You know, the bare minimums back then. We broke, you know.
Come on, man.
With the stash in it.
Yeah.
Anyway, I go pick 3-2 up from the airport, and he, Bobo, check this out. And he put this cassette in. He said, these little young boys about to be some stars. One with a trigger, two with a...
Who is that? That's me. I say that every week. That's the first one I heard.
It was about 3 songs on there.
That's the first one I heard. Yeah. I know where I heard it just like you and when I heard it.
Yeah. For some reason, they gave us this great big dressing room. And everybody's
in our dressing room.
I'm talking about Short is in our dressing room. Spice is in our dressing room. And the promoter, of course, is being funny with the money.
Of course, that's
everybody's in there talking about why this dude ain't paying us enough. And we in the Cajun Dome, I don't know if you ever been there. It's packed.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, to the wall. It's like, whatever it hold.
It was in there.
Yeah.
Capacity full.
Capacity. It's full to capacity. Mm-hmm. That's an inside joke, man. My wife. Anyway, so it's filled to capacity. And here comes Pimp and Bun. First, here comes Bun. Bun is real, you know, jovial, you know, kicking it with everybody. I got pictures from that night, I'll show you.
Yeah.
And next thing you know, here comes Pimp.
Cool.
So really, Pimp, what they had done, they had befriended two girls from Dallas that were strippers.
Okay.
You know, KT, what's up? They're my homegirls now. But he walked in with them, looking like a pimp, acting like a pimp. And so I said, who is this cat? And he's pissed off by his rooms, pissed off about the money. And I said, damn, this nigga another level. I ain't like him at first. He came in showing his ass.
Yeah.
And so, he started talking about, oh, y'all from Dallas, boo, 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 bro, I see y'all, boo, boo, you know, boo, boo, boo. And then after the show, we really kicked it. You know what I'm saying? They had a little after party and whatnot. And he told us, we just signed the Jive.
Well.
And we're going to record the album, finish the album in Dallas. The night I got the Bobo tattoo was the first night I met Screw. Master P came through. So we were DJ Screwheads.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Before the Michael Watts and all that came out.
Yeah.
But so when all that came out, he was in jail. Well, I take that back. They were bubbling, but he didn't have relationships with them. But when he got out, they had all gone platinum.
Yeah.
Mike Jones, Flip, Powwow, Slim, you know, so they all have names now.
T-Row was doing his thing.
So they had went from being, you know, small, underground, to stars, to beefing.
Yeah.
And he felt like, why? Yeah, he's like, Bobo, what the fuck? They gonna take this shit from us. Because he was all about the South.
South, that's right, Texas. You know,
the South is too big.
And the whole South, actually.
Yeah, the whole South, man.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That quit hating the South, man. That quit hating the South, man.
That boy hate, I'm going to say, he didn't hate we know the other coast.
He
didn't play about this one.
That's what we knew.
He did not play about Texas. He didn't play about Port Arthur, and he didn't play about the South.
Yeah, we on Boss Talk 101.